So now we'll discuss the image formation in the convex mirror, right? So image formation in the convex mirror, right? The image formation in the convex mirror. Now see, actually when we draw a convex mirror, children, now we have done it n number of times, so we are all used to it. We understand now this one mm dash is the reflecting surface. This is the principal axis xy, right? And then we have focus and we have center of curvature. Now we know it very nicely, like focus and center of curvature of the convex mirror are at the back side, right? They are at the back side. Now wherever you keep the object, whenever the object is kept in the front, okay, front, this is the front part. So whenever the object is kept at the front part, so the image formation will always takes place behind the mirror, okay? Whenever the image, whenever the object is kept anywhere, anywhere here in the front side, the object is kept here in the front side, the image formation will take place behind the mirror. Whenever the image formation is taking place behind the mirror, that means this is not the real image which is formed, because the rays, these rays after reflection, they cannot come here, they cannot pass this polished surface. That means whatever rays are we drawing over here, those all rays will be virtual rays, isn't it? So whenever the, you know, image will be formed in this way, so virtual images will be formed. Now whenever virtual image is formed, virtual images are always which kind, like what they are? So they are the real, virtual means they are the erect images, right? Virtual images are always erect images. So this, remember this point, that whenever the object, we are talking about convex mirror now, whenever the object is kept in front of the mirror, convex mirror, the image formation will takes place behind the mirror. Whenever the image formation takes place behind the mirror, definitely that image will be virtual. If the image is virtual, that means definitely it is erect, and in this case the diminished images have formed. Now here we'll talk about the two cases, right, in the convex mirror. In first case, we keep the object anywhere, okay, anywhere between the pole and the infinity, right? So it is kept anywhere between pole and infinity. Here we are going to keep the object anywhere between the pole and the infinity, right? So let me keep the object here, right? This is my object AB. See, whenever you try to make ray diagrams, always remember few things which we have discussed earlier also while discussing the image formation, the concave mirror. The same thing will be followed here also. Like the, you know, whenever you draw the object, you have to, you know, name it. This all has to be named, isn't it? Now this is named as AB. So we will be talking about only two rays to minimize the confusion, to make the ray diagrams very easily and to understand it very, very properly. So only two rays will be discussing about, one which usually we go with the ray, you know, we make a ray which is parallel to the principal axis, and the second ray which we do is the, you know, which we draw is the one which passes to the center of the curvature. So here also, this is an object which has its arrow towards the, you know, the arrow headed object is there. Now one ray we are considering, this ray to come, a parallel ray is coming which is incident at this point D, right? A parallel ray is coming. Now definitely I have to make arrow. This ray is coming from this top part of the object. It is parallel to principal axis, and what is happening, it is getting reflected, right? It gets reflected in this way. But we know, but we know that whenever a parallel ray, a ray which is passing, or a parallel ray incident on any reflecting surface which is parallel to the principal axis, then it needs to pass through where? It needs to pass through the focus, right? So I will increase this backwards and allow it to pass through the focus, right? I will allow it to pass through the focus now. So what is happening over here? A ray of light which is parallel to the principal axis, after reflection it is going over there, but it will appear to come from the focus. Now second ray which we will be trying to, you know, I'll be drawing over here, which I want to pass from the center of curvature. So this ray which is passing, you know, like it is coming over here, but as this is a convex mirror, it is print, it is polished from this side, it cannot go over there. But I'll draw the, you know, the dotted line, I'll extend it to the center of curvature, right? And this one, it will, like here it has come over here, and from it will pass to the center of curvature. No, not in reality. It will take back the same path, it will trace the same path, and it will, you know, it will move towards this side. So suppose if we consider this point as AE, so AE will be incident ray, whereas EA will be reflected ray. This we have done n number of times, so I do not think now there should be any kind of confusion. So sorry. Now see, again I'm we will be discussing this. This is the mirror MM dash. This is the principal axis X and Y, right? Now this is the pole. Now this is the object AB. Now we are considering two rays, right? We are considering two rays. Now this object is kept somewhere between the pole and the infinity. Now the first ray which is coming from the head, or from this arrowhead, it is parallel to the principal axis, so it has to pass through the focus. It get reflected in this way, but what we have done, we have extended, something is wrong with my pronunciation today. So we have extended this line, this ray, towards the focus. Now the second ray, definitely we want this ray to pass through the center of curvature. Why we are doing so? So it will never happen that there will be only two rays which is passing through. But again I am telling that to make our diagram simpler, to make our, you know, to make our understanding, you know, clear, we are taking only two rays. So one ray we have taken which is parallel to the principal axis, and after reflection, you know, it appears to come from the focus. Second one which passes through the center of curvature, but actually it is not passing through the center of curvature, we are extending it to the center of curvature. But what is happening when this ray is falling perpendicularly over here, it traces the same path and moves back, right? So AE is the incident ray, but EA is the reflected ray. Now when we when we have extended these two rays, we get a point over here. Okay, we get a point over here which we can name it as A dash. And when we draw a perpendicular line over here, so what will happen? We will get an, you know, we will get an image over here. Now, which kind of image is formed, children? Here, the behind the mirror image is formed. Behind the mirror, right? Then it is virtual because it is not formed in real. You know, we have extended the this rays. Now behind the mirror, actually it is not happening, so it is virtual and erect image, and it is diminished. Diminished image or very small image is formed, right? So we can see over here very small image is formed, right? So now we'll talk about the second image formation. Okay, now here in this case, what we have to imagine, like, you know, here we have kept the object somewhere between the pole and the infinity. And now in the second case, we'll imagine like a object is there somewhere at infinity, right? So again I'll have to draw a convex mirror. Now this is the polished surface. Now this is the principal axis X and Y. Now somewhere at infinity, I cannot draw over here, isn't it, because infinity is like very far. So somewhere at infinity an arrow headed, like it means in the same way. Okay, an object is kept. Now two rays are coming from that object, right? Two rays are coming from that object, one in this way and the other in this way. Now I have to name this. So first of all, this is our pole. Okay, now this I can name it as A, B and D, E, right? We have to imagine that the object is kept somewhere at infinity. From that object, from the top of the object, right? Top of that object, two rays are coming and these two rays are parallel to each other. From the arrow-headed erect object, two rays are coming from the top of that object and these two rays are parallel to each other. So what is happening? These are coming from infinity and definitely this should be the sign of the like from where it is coming. Now after reflection it moves definitely like this. So this can be F and again this can be like this. So this I have mentioned as G. So what is happening? From somewhere the object, where the object is kept, from there the top, from the top of the object two rays are coming which are parallel to each other. So AB is the ray first which incident on the point B and get reflected as the BF. Okay, get reflected as BF. Now here the second ray DE is coming which is again parallel to this ray. It get reflected at point E and incident at point E and from E it get reflected as EG. So incident rays are what? AB and DE, and reflected rays are what? BF and EG. Now if I extend, see these rays backwards, right? If I extend these rays backward, so I get one point, okay? I get one point and this point I can name it as A dash, and when I draw a perpendicular to the principal axis then I'll get one more point which is known as B dash. So here the image formation takes place and this image formation takes place at the focus, right? Now which kind of image is formed, children? First of all, the image is formed where? It is formed behind the mirror, right? Behind the mirror, image formation has taken place at the at the back of the mirror. In the beginning only we have discussed that in the convex mirror, wherever you keep the object, okay, in front if you keep the object, at the back you cannot keep the object, isn't it? So wherever you keep the object, what will happen? The image formation will take place at behind the mirror, at the back side of the mirror. Now whenever behind the mirror the image formation is taking place, that means the virtual image will be formed. If it is virtual, then it will be erect. Erect, virtual and erect image will be formed and this image is highly diminished. Highly diminished image will be formed. So these are the two cases of the convex mirror where we have seen like how the image formation takes place. In the first case, we have kept the object, where? Somewhere between the pole and the infinity. And in second case, we have imagined that the object is somewhere at the infinity, and from there the two parallel rays are coming from the top of that object, and after reflection it moves like this. But when we extend these rays at the back of the mirror, virtually, so it meet at a point. Now we get this point as A dash. Now when we draw perpendicular to this point, we find that image formation takes place at the focus. Now which kind of image will be formed? Definitely behind the mirror image is formed. When behind the mirror image formation takes place, that then it is definitely a virtual image, and virtual images are always erect images. And here we can see like it is highly diminished, very small images formed, right? So now this for here we have discussed about the two cases of the convex mirror, how the image formation will takes place, right? Now we'll talk about the uses of the convex mirror. Now what are the uses of the convex mirror, children? See, the first use of the convex mirror, see, one thing you need to understand now, children, like when we talk about the plane mirrors, right? When we talk about the plane mirrors, so which kind of image is seen? Normal you can be seen in, when you see yourself in the plane mirror at home, your normal mirror where you see, you dress up yourself, so you see yourself as normal person. But when we show in plane, you see yourself as you are, right? Now when we talk about the concave mirrors, so if you remember, if you try to see yourself, that enlarged image will be formed, isn't it? Enlarged image will be formed. And when we talk about the convex mirror, we have taken discuss here two signs, you know, and here I can make it more smaller actually. So it will be highly diminished, right? So here in in plane mirror you will be able to see yourself as you are, in concave mirror you will find yourself enlarged one, and in convex you will see like you yourself, if you want to see, you will see a very diminished image, a very small image. Now the uses of these mirrors will be definitely based on their properties, how do they behave, definitely. So concave mirror, that is the reason that, you know, and one more thing, like these are concave mirrors are converging mirrors and convex mirrors are diverging mirror, that also has to be kept in mind. Concave is converging and convex are diverging, so this point also has to be kept in mind, right? Because of their properties, which property? First one, that enlarged image is formed, and second one, the mirror is converged. So we have seen the uses of concave mirror, where they are used, they can be used in the jewelry shop, where the, you know, bigger images, when where they want to show like, yeah, so many pieces of jewelry are kept, isn't it? It can be used as a shaving mirror, the makeup mirror, the dentist mirror, isn't it? The reflector, you know, the torches, the searchlights, where the, you know, the light has to be very, the beam has to be very strong, convergence property is utilized, or the enlarged image is utilized, isn't it? Now second one, the convex, when we talk about, so here the image which is formed is very small, so that is the reason it is used for rear view images, rear view mirrors. Now what is the meaning of this rear view mirrors? It means the back mirror, okay, back mirror. Now back mirror are the mirrors which are used by the drivers, even we drive, isn't it? When we drive our cars, when we ride our vehicles, two wheelers, we see in the mirror, like, you know, which vehicle or how many vehicles are coming from the back side. So what is happening, you know, it gives a larger view, like it gives a larger view in a diminished form, okay? That is the reason we can see all large area of our back side. So they are used in rear view mirrors, which are used as the, you know, the mirrors in the cars, trucks, buses, as the to see the back view. Diminished images are formed, okay, diminished images are formed, and so we see all the things which are coming, all the vehicles which are coming back, and all can be seen because they become very diminished, and larger view is there, and they are erect also. Now when we talk about the concave mirror, children, just imagine if you use concave mirror in this rear view mirror. So what is happening in concave mirror? The images which are formed are not erect because they are not virtual most of the times. So inverted images are formed. So just imagine, children, you are driving your car, and when you see in your rear view mirror, in that mirror where you can see the backside thing, na? So when you just look over there, if you use the concave mirror, all the trucks and buses will look very funny because they will be like the inverted images will be formed all upside down. So the trucks will be moving with the tires up. So it will become very funny and you won't be able to understand. That is the reason here the convex mirror are used. So that is the thing which I am telling again, that these uses of the mirrors totally depends upon their properties. So you need to understand and remember the properties of the mirrors. So here the diminished and erect image is formed, here enlarged image is formed. So if you use this concave mirror, only you will be able to see one or the other truck, and the rest of the road you won't be able to see, because only one image is going to cover everything, and that like very enlarged image will be formed, that too inverted one, all funny images, tires up. So here diminished and erect, and so we use this mirror. Apart from this, you know, this mirrors can also be used as shop security. shop security mirrors, you know, actually for doing this, shop security mirrors, you know, a very, you know, a perfect place has to be looked out. From where the, if you place the mirror, the total view of the shop can be seen. See now what is the difference, children? We use concave mirror in the jewelry shop because we want to show things enlarged, bigger, multiple one. But in convex mirror, we put this as a security mirror where we want to see everything what is going on in the shop from every angle and corner, but in a very small way. If we place concave mirror over here, what will happen? We'll see bigger images and we won't be able to identify the thing, you know, the all particular locations. This convex mirror gives the larger area image. So again, in the shop security, for shop security purposes also, the convex mirrors are used, right? So these are the uses of the convex mirror, like the mainly the for the rear view, you know, the back mirrors, and for the shop security purposes, so that everything what is going on in the shop can be viewed at, you know, looking just somewhere at one mirror at one glance only, right? So now this was all about the concave and convex mirror. We have discussed the rules for the image formation both in concave and convex mirrors. We have also seen the image formation in the concave and the convex mirrors, right? Now if you want to make the chart, only two images are there, so it's not so difficult, okay? So that's the reason I'm not making the chart over here. And we have also discussed the uses of the concave and convex mirror. So now we'll move to the next topic. Please note this. Thank you.